Good morning, students. We are here for the last lecture of unit number 3, skewness, where we are going to study Bobolev's coefficient of skewness, a continuous series problem. In last lectures, we finished the individual series problem, discrete series problem, and the third, which is now a continuous series problem. So here our unit number 3 will get finished. So in this particular problem, we are going to see the continuous series of Bobolev's coefficient of skewness. First, we will read the problem and then we will move to the next slide, next page. As you see that this problem has already been asked in Nagpur University examination of summer 2013. Calculate Bobolev's coefficient of skewness from the following information. Marks and number of students 0 to 10, 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, 50 to 60, 60 to 70, 70 to 80. Frequencies is being given accordingly 5, 8, 7, 12, 28, 20, 10 and again 10. So this is a problem of continuous series. Let us go to next slide and get explained that problem. So this first the frequency is being given here. So it is being written here, the frequency and then cumulative frequency, because we are solving median, so that's why there is a need of cumulative frequency. There is no need to convert the series, because series is already being in a proper way. We just have to prepare a cumulative frequency. So 5 plus 8 13, 13 plus 7 20, 20 plus 12 32, 32 plus 28 60, 60 plus 20 80, 80 plus 10 90, 90 plus 10 100. So the value of n equals to 100. So we had prepared the table, which is our requirement, a basic requirement to calculate our values of q1, q3 and median, because to solve the problem of Bobolev's coefficient of skewness, as I mentioned earlier lectures also, we have to calculate q1, we have to calculate q3 and we have to calculate median. So now q1 equals to size of n by 4th item, the size of 100 by 4th item as n equals to 100, the size of 100 divided by 4th item, the size of 25th item. Now we have to locate the size of 25th item. It will get located in 32. So therefore the group is 32 40. Now by interpolation formula, q1 equals to l1 plus l2 minus l1 divided by f1 q1 minus c. l1 equals to 30, the lowest value of the group, plus L2 equals to 40, the highest value of the group, 40 minus 30 divided by 12, because our group is 30, 40. So L1 is 30, the lowest value, and L2 equals to 40, highest value. F1 is 12, the frequency of that located group, okay, multiplied by Q1, the value that we located, that is 25. And C is a preceding cumulative frequency, that is 20. So all values we had placed in that particular formula, L1 30 plus L2 40 minus L1 30 divided by F1 12, the group value, the frequency of that particular group, multiplied by Q1 25, that we had the 25th item was there, minus 20 preceding cumulative frequency of 32. So I hope you understand this thing very well. Now we will solve this step by step. So 30 plus 40 minus 30, 10 divided by 12 multiplied by 25 minus 25. Now 30 plus 10 multiplied by 5 divided by 12, 30 plus 50 divided by 12. So 30 plus 50 divided by 12 will be 4.166. So it will be 34.166. So this is our first answer, that is of Q1. So we had find out Q1, we have found out Q1. So Q1 equals to 34.166. Now we will move to we will skip median, we will move to Q3. This is a Q, this is not the median, okay? It's a printing mistake. It is Q3. Q3 equals to, this is Q3, okay? Let me do it. It is not that much easy to write with this pen here. So it is Q3, okay? The size of 3, n by 2th item. The size of 3, 100 divided by 4th item, the size of 3, 25th item, the size of 75th atom. Now we have to locate that size of 75th atom. That 75th atom will get located in 80. The group will be 50 to 60. The frequency, the value of F1 will be 20, and cumulative value, the value of C will be 60. So these are the values that we needed for the calculation of Q3. So Q3 equals to L1 plus L2 minus L1 divided by F1, Q3 minus C, L1 50, the group was 50 to 60, plus L2 60, 60 minus 50 divided by 20, Q3 the 75th atom minus 60 is a cumulative frequency. So we had all those values that we needed. So we will now solve this. 50 plus 60 minus 50, 10 divided by 20 multiplied by 75 minus 60, 15. Now 50 plus 10 multiplied by 15, 150 divided by 20. So 50 plus 7.5, it will be 57.5. So answer of Q3 is 57.5. So now we have Q1 and we have Q3. Now we will go for median. The size of n by 2th item, the size of 100 by 2th item, the size of 50th item in the cumulative frequency. Now 50th item will get in a located in cumulative frequency of 60. So the group will be 40 to 50. Okay. Now we will calculate median. So m equals the pi interpolation formula. M equals to L1 plus L2 minus L1 divided by F1 F minus C. 40 plus 50, 40, 50, the group was, let me check, 40 to 50, okay. L1 40 plus 50 minus 40 divided by F, the frequency is 28 and cumulative frequency is 32. So 28. In bracket 50 minus 32, 40 plus 10 divided by 28 multiplied by 18, 40 plus 10 multiplied by 18 divided by 28, 40 plus 180 divided by 28, 40 plus 6.428, so it is 46.428. So we have median also. The answer is 46.428. So now we have Q1, Q3 and median. Now we'll place up all those items in our formula of coefficient of skewness. Bowles coefficient of skewness formula is J equals to Q3 plus Q1 minus 2m divided by Q3 minus Q1. Q3 55.5 it is 57.5, okay. We just have to find Q1 equals to 34.166. Okay, that will be 57.5 plus 34.166 minus 2 in bracket 46.428. 57.5 minus 34.166. Here it is a printing mistake. And then it will just have to cross check this answer because there was a printing mistake here. So after doing the calculation, you will get the answer of Bowles coefficient of skewness. I hope it will be negative coefficient of skewness. So this is the problem of continuous series of Bowles coefficient of skewness. We had the problem in individual series, we have a problem of discrete series, and we have a problem in continuous series. So this is the end of unit number 3, where we studied two methods. One is Carl Pearson's coefficient of skewness, and another is Bowles coefficient of skewness. I tried to cover each and every series for these two methods. So while seeing the lectures, while seeing this video lectures, you might get that we had solved the problems of individual series, discrete series and continuous series for both Carl Pearson coefficient of skewness and Bowles coefficient of skewness. The third method that was there, Cayley's coefficient of skewness, that was not the part of our syllabus. So I hope you understand this unit number 3 very well. This is the end of our unit number 3. Next lecture we will start unit number 4, which is the last part of our syllabus, which have the contents of mathematics, business mathematics. As you know, the name of our subject is business statistics and business mathematics. first three units are of statistics that we had completed. The last unit is of mathematics, business mathematics, that we will start from the next lecture. I will change the delivery of methodology of lectures from next lecture, as we will go to the classroom, and from a classroom environment I will teach you the fourth unit of business mathematics, because they are short problems. There are short problems, and it will be easy for us to understand those problems with the help of blackboards. So here we will end the unit number 3. For unit number 4, we will meet in the next lecture. Thank you. Thank you very much.